The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Robin, I've got bad news. I left the bat belt at home.
So I have to do everything?
You're in charge!
Yeah, one ticket to the Titanic, please.
The evil wizard must be defeated, but somebody else could do it, right?
Sean Bean, I'm the star of this show.
Why is there a guillotine?
A lot of laughs for the Sean Bean reference. Okay, this next one is what you don't want to hear over the intercom. So I'm going to give you guys access to the mic for this. What you don't want to hear over the intercom.
This is your own captain speaking, and pretty sure we're about to be on the ground a lot sooner than expected. So, buckle up.
Come on, you can't resist this mic, it's so powerful.
We have a 2-year-old at the welcome desk.
Oh my god.
Paging a doctor. Is there a doctor in the building? Is there a nurse in the building? Is there anyone who knows any life-saving technique? Okay, fine. Is there a mortician in the building?
We also need a firefighter. We also need a chef. We're everyone left. We have no employee.
Attention, Kmart shoppers. This is a vacant building. Please check out. Nobody shops at Kmart.
My name's Zoe.
Zoe?
Okay. Yeah.
And you went Source
Bay? Yeah, we went First Source Bay.
First Source Bay?
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, we're a smaller, like, community bank. We're, our home, like, our main branch is in South Bend. So,
I heard if you want to get a loan, your best one is a community bank. And, they like to loan money to local people, right?
Yeah, we do. We do a lot for the community. We're very local, very, so.
Very good. Where are you located at?
Well, we have, is it 12?
12 in Fort Wayne.
Yeah, we have 12 in Fort Wayne. We have 12 locations in the Fort Wayne and the Fort Wayne area. So, like, Fort Wayne, Bluffton, Huntington, Columbia City, and our newest branch is up in Auburn.
And who do you have
with
you?
This is Gabby.
What's your name?
My name is Heather Gordon.
And who are you with here, Heather?
I am with Crossroads Kombucha and Indiana Tea Brewery.
And what, okay, what
the,
you say a brew?
Yes.
Wow, you make beer or what?
We brew our kombucha and we brew our tea. This is our Indiana sweet tea. It's not a southern sweet, it's Hoosier Tea Daddy.
Oh, okay.
It's a lightly sweetened, and then we ferment this to make the kombucha.
Wow, and what's the difference? From kombucha from regular tea.
Kombucha is its whole different thing. It is nice and light and refreshing. The fermentation process of the tea creates billions of probiotics for your gut health. It also creates naturally occurring glucosamine, branch strain amino acids, and a natural anti-inflammatory.
Wow.
The probiotics go in there. They're the good bacteria that go in your belly. They eat away that bad bacteria, and they level out that playing field for your gut health.
It's like guts being crossroads.
That's right. That's right.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Where do we find you at?
We are right here in Fort Wayne. We sell at over 70 locations now. We are at Fresh Time. We are at Core Life Eatery, the Co-op. We are at the North Anthony Health Food Shop.
At the mall?
We are not at the mall,
okay.
But we do sell down at all the colleges now.
Oh, okay.
At Indiana and Ball State. We're down in Dayton. We are selling up in South Bend at the Purple Porch. So we're getting it going.
Well, everybody at home, we need to see what that kombucha,
right? Oh, it's delicious. It's very light and bubbly.
Wow.
We pride ourselves on making our kombucha palatable.
That makes me thirsty thinking about
it. Well, you're more than welcome to have a sample.
I'd love to have
yes.
a sample.
Yes. Yeah.
Can you have a sample?
Yes. This is our blueberry sage.
Okay.
This is the first flavor we ever made. And it's light, it's bubbly. Not very sweet.
Wow.
So it's not like a tea or a soda.
Yeah, it tastes a little like wine.
It's the fermentation. So we have no added color, sugar, or flavor.
Uh-huh.
It's all from the berries itself. But how about a little swig of our sweet tea?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's good.
So this is a blend of green, mostly green with a little black and a little oolong there at the end. We have no preservatives. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, and it's low sugar.
Even though it's low sugar, it's very sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, we tried to be like grandma's sweet tea.
You are, you are.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome. Thanks for stopping by. This is Kylie. She's another one of our associates here at Crossroads Kombucha. She was down at the YLNI Farmers Market on Bar Street this morning. Just came to give me a little break.
Well, thank you, Kayla, for coming down. Okay, thank you so much.
Cool. Yeah, so we're with...
What's your name?
My name is Brad. I'm with B. Antonio's Pizza. We've got two locations here in town. We're up at Lima and DuPont. And then our other location is over at Chapel Ridge.
What's best about you?
We are a locally owned restaurant. We use the highest quality ingredients that we can find for stuff. Yeah, fresh ingredients. We cook up a lot of our own meats. It's really good stuff.
Can you
Yep, we do delivery, we do dine-in, carry-out. Phone number, we've got two different locations. It's actually best just to check us out online at our website. We've got online ordering as well. This is Brayden, he's one of my top workers over at our Chapel Ridge location.
Yes, I do.
Master chef right here, yep.
Cool.
We've been in town for 15 years now. Yep, yep. Yeah, yeah, yep. Been here for a long time, locally owned, so check us out. Cool, appreciate it. Thank you.
This is Elizabeth. Uh-huh. I have my son, Nico. My daughter Mia.
It looks like you find a nice place that you don't have a picnic.
Yes. Yeah, out of the sun. Yeah.
Very, very wise move.
Thank you.
Well, it looks like people that haven't came on here are really missing out.
Yeah, oh yeah. It's been, we've had a really good time. Don't you
yeah,
think?
It's been really fun.
What's one of your favorite things you've seen?
Well, we went out and tried some instruments over there, and that was pretty fun, I thought.
All right.
Good. Good. So, what about you, Nico? Did you have a favorite?
We tried out to add some
instruments. It looks like you might have seen the balloon man, huh?
Did you like the balloon man?
Uh-huh.
All right.
And it popped on.
Yeah. It did get popped a little bit. Yeah,
okay. Thank you very much. Is there anything else you want to say to the people?
No, just, you know, yeah, they're missing out. Yeah. Come on out and check it out. See what's happening. It's fun. Yeah.
Garland, I'm an artist, primarily a photographer, and an abstract painter in Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Great. What are some of the pictures you've done?
My pictures, mostly I do, like, Instagram work and documentary stuff for, like... do I take pictures of different buildings? Oh, murals on buildings? I primarily do like street art, like so it's like I paint on the street. There's one of them over there, the Connecting Museum. And there's another one entirely on Calhoun Street over there. Yeah, go throw some balloons down there.
Yeah, come on through, we're right over here on Calhoun.
Oh, I'm just with Adam over here, so volunteering.
You can find everything out here today.
You sure can. And tell us a little bit about your
booth here. Yeah, this is FAME Arts. FAME stands for the Foundation of Music and Arts and Education.
Okay.
So we work with educators to bring arts and crafts, music. My name's Ella Eagle.
Ella? Okay.
Yep. And so today we're bubble painting.
How do you bubble paint?
Well, I'll give you a little demonstration.
All right.
You pick the color you want. I'll go with orange today so I match my apron.
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
And you take your straw.
Wow.
And once the bubbles go on there, it makes fun little bubble patterns.
Wow, isn't that clever?
Wow.
I've never seen that before.
That is bubble painting.
There's samples of it too.
Bubble painting. That is so clever. Thank you very much. And who do you have here with you?
This is my granddaughter.
Right. And you bubble paint too, don't
yes.
you?
Yeah. Friends in the family.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
Of course. Love.
make me wanna laugh so hard I'm holding my stomach. You make me wanna cry rivers of joyful, awestruck tears. I never knew love could make me wanna do so much at once.
Voter rights and voter registration, and also redistricting, which is the thing that they are doing now to redraw the lines for which candidates are going to have which parts of the state that they will represent. And every 10 years, this is a project that they do to redistribute the population in conjunction with the census. And we want to make sure that those maps are fair and they are informed by citizen input and that they are representative of the voters in their area.
How important is it that we vote?
Your vote is your voice. If you don't vote, you can't complain. The first step in voting is to have a good candidate to vote for and a good competition to engage voters in the process. And so redistricting is very important for that, because if the district is so biased one way or the other that there isn't much of a contest, then good people don't participate, because they're not interested.
Right. Well, who do you have here with you?
I have Sharon Busick-Howell, who was the immediate past president of our Fort Wayne League and a longtime supporter of Rights for All. We have a newsletter and we would love people to do that. I also want to introduce you to Jerry, our gerrymandering salamander, who is pro fair maps and part of the Indiana's Citizens Coalition for Redistricting and All In for Democracy. So Jerry says, pay attention, let your legislators know that you're paying attention, and we want fair maps.
Fair maps? What is fair maps?
Well, fair maps for the people is drawing a map so that it represents the people in the district. So one of the concerns with this map is that for the Senate districts, they've chosen to split Fort Wayne into three pieces. And so there's a lot of people who are concerned that the people like on the south side of Fort Wayne don't have a whole lot of common with the people who live in Huntington, but they're in the same district. That doesn't really make very much sense. So the idea is to keep community of interest together, to draw it so that it is representative and competitive, so that people will be engaged in the process.
I'm one of the inspectors.
Oh, very good.
I become an inspector.
All right, very good. Well, thank you for participating in the process.
Yes, I do.
That's excellent.
Anything else you want to
do? If you would like to check your voter registration, go to indianavoters.in.gov, and you may look and make sure that your registration is current, that your address is correct. If you've gotten married or changed status in some way since the last election, you can update that and you can be ready to vote. We don't have any contests coming up this November, but next year is a big year.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Is there a number we can get hold of yet?
No, but you can go to our website, which is lwvfw.org.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can. This is Angela, and we are with Wagon Wheel Center for the Arts in Warsaw. Uh-huh. And these are the brochures about our upcoming shows. We've got our community theater show that has one in September, and our junior program, we'll do one in October. Then we've got the Rocky Horror Show and at Halloween, and our professional Christmas show in December.
Which is Elf.
That'll be Elf.
Do you have a website or a phone number?
We do. It's wagonwheelcenter.org. And then right down here is our brochure about our summer season for next year.
Okay. And Reagan, you want to tell the people at home about Wagon
Wheel? Oh, gosh. Everybody should come check out a show.
You can be eating a meal while you're watching the show,
Not at Wagon Wheel.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But you can go next door and eat and then come watch a show. And you're only ever 10 rows from all of the actors. So that's pretty cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's very cool. Yeah, we have actors from all over the place that come and do shows.
Good, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Enjoy.
We will.
Hi, guys.
My name is Rachel Jones.
Hey, Rachel. And are you with Dance Collective?
Yep, Fort Wayne Dance Collective.
Can you tell us what that is?
Yeah, absolutely. So Fort Wayne Dance Collective is a local arts organization, and our mission is to provide movement and rhythm to people of all ages and abilities. So we have tons of programming for anyone and everyone, whether you've never taken a dance class in your life or you're a seasoned professional.
Where do we meet at?
Where do we meet at? We are located on the corner of Clay and Berry at 437 East Berry, upstairs in the Hall Community Arts Center.
And how often?
All the time. We've got our fall semester actually starting on Monday, and we run classes all throughout the year, and our programs run throughout the year as well.
Do you have a website?
Yes, www.fwdc.org.
Do you have a phone number?
260-424-6574. This is Gwen Baer. Gwen has taken classes at our on-site school, and she's a volunteer with the organization.
You dance it, right?
Yeah, I do a little bit of tap classes with Rachel. She's my teacher and instructor, and I also volunteer for the collective.
Very good.
Thank you.
What's your favorite dance?
My favorite what?
Dance.
My favorite style of dance is tap, hands down. I am a tapper through and through, and I love it.
I know it's awful as well.
Oh, probably.
Step it off hard.
Sure. I don't, but yeah. I can give you something.
Can
so.
Really?
Sure, okay. Why not? We'll give some time steps.
Wow.
Yeah, anyway.
All right. Yeah. On the fly, you came right out and did it. Yeah.
I love to dance.
Yep.
So.
Thank you. I can see that in
you. Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, and both of you.
Fort Wayne Philharmonic. I've seen a bunch of different philharmonics. They have the jazz, they have rock and roll, they have, according to what group it is. So I'm going to ask them some questions here at the Philharmonic, okay? I'm familiar with the Philharmonic, and I know that there's different types of bands, like you have the jazz band, you have rock and roll.
Yeah.
What all types of ensembles do you have?
Well, on our schedule this year, it's really cool. We're doing a lot of fun things. So Disney music, we're doing a whole concert that plays Disney classic music.
Okay.
And the more classical, like the Freiman series, has those different ensembles.
You ever played the Freiman something?
Yes. Okay. Yep. Yep.
Okay. When you go meet the Freiman again, you know?
Yes. I think the starting date is in October. So our concerts start in October. So the first set's in October.
Okay.
It'll be at the History Center and then at PFW. You can see all those ensembles.
Good,
and then we have
good.
Free ones popping up throughout too, at Crescendo, down at the Clyde, or at Sweetwater.
And what's your name?
My name is Sarah.
Sarah?
Mm-hmm.
And Sarah, do you play an instrument too?
I do not.
You don't? I bet you sing though.
No. I have no talent. So
I
that's
bet
why
you carry over.
I can do that.
Yeah, you can do
after a couple beers.
Yeah. Well, great. Thank you very much.
Please take a bag, take a sip.
Dan Ross.
Hi, Dan. And you're a volunteer for the Taste of the Arts?
I am. I'm actually on staff with Arts United, but we have many volunteers who are helping us out, and we always appreciate the volunteers. We could not do this festival without volunteer help.
How
and
do
so,
we become volunteers?
Well, if you would like to volunteer for the Taste of the Arts Festival, we would love to have you come to our website. And for next year's festival, we will sign you up and we will gladly put you to work and we'll give you a good looking t-shirt.
Wow.
So thank you so much. We hope you'll join us next year.
Okay, looks
thank
like
you.
We have another Taste of the Arts with you. Who do you have with you? You have your first name?
I'm sorry.
What's your first name?
My name's Megan.
Hi, So is this your first year making pies?
I would really rather not be on camera, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Is this your first year?
No, I've been doing this ever since the beginning.
Wow!
Yeah, okay. And it's a fantastic event. Thank you so much. We appreciate you being here.
Okay, what's your name?
My name's Elise Faulkner. I'm the Education and Programs Manager at the Auburn Cord Duesenberg Automobile Museum.
What is that? What is Duesenberg?
So we showcase cars, specifically Auburns, Cords, and Duesenbergs, and lots of other vehicles as well. All from as early as pre-1900 until the end of the Auburn Automobile Company in 1937. So we're at the home of the original Auburn Automobile Company's showroom and their...
And this week, it's all going on this week, right?
Yes, so this next coming week is going to be the Auburn Cord Duesenberg Festival, so we'll be hanging out. We'll have tons of visitors. We'll have some really awesome cars on display, and we'll have tons of cool events going on that week.
Wow, okay. And I hear you have a parade coming up, too.
Yes, absolutely. So on Saturday, we'll have the parade. You can see lots of really cool classic cars. Lots of really interesting people are going to be there. Some cool racing legends and things like that. So definitely come check us out.
You don't want to miss that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. And come see us.
And what's your name?
Hi, I'm Norm.
Norm? And can you tell us about the radio station? Yeah.
WELT 95.7 FM is community radio. Of course, it's non-commercial radio, and it represents the community. We've got a mix of talk and music. WELT stands for We Encourage Local Talent.
And so somebody could actually come with a message they'd like to get to people and actually get on the radio?
Yes, indeed. Yes. This is, like I said, it's the people's radio. We do all kinds of different shows, some live, some recorded, and the radio station plays 24/7. So yeah, if you want to be a DJ, come talk with us. We also have a online as far as the website, acbl.welt. You can check that out as far as and actually get started to be a DJ that way.
Can you tell us your phone number?
Yeah, the call us at the main library is 421-1250.
Thank you very much, Norm. Thank you. And tell us, I see a lot of instruments here. Tell us about yourself and your...
Yeah, so I'm here with Sweetwater Band and Orchestra. We brought an instrument petting zoo. And so kids or adults can come in and try out flute, clarinet, saxophone, trumpet or trombone. Just try and make a sound and see what they can do.
This petting zoo, you can't get bit.
If you're doing it right, you won't get bit.
You play an instrument?
I play French horn.
French horn?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have a French horn in
your... I don't, unfortunately.
Okay. Do you play an instrument? You do.
She plays flute.
I'm Diane.
Hi, Diane. What instrument do you play?
I play flute.
I see one there. Can you blow a note?
That's a good question. I haven't done it for a long time.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure I could, but you don't need to hear it.
I don't need to hear it? Okay, but we just know you can do it.
That's right.
Where did you learn to play the flute?
Where did I what?
Learn. Where did you learn?
Oh, I learned in elementary school, high school, and college, and then I taught band for 42 years. So.
And in this booth we have here, how does this help you now?
It fills my passion.
Okay.
I love music, I love band, and I know how valuable band is for young people.
No, I'm not sure. Do you sell instruments or how does that work?
Yes, they actually do. Okay. They sell it through Sweetwater.
Oh, this is Sweetwater.
Right,
okay.
Right.
Very good, I understand. I guess I didn't know this was happening.
Yeah, there's no sign out here right now, but definitely Sweetwater. Used to be my nets over on Hobson.
Yeah.
And then Sweetwater bought out my nets. So that's all part of Sweetwater now.
I love Sweetwater. They're so supportive of Fort Wayne.
Absolutely. Very
really
much.
I love them here in Fort Wayne.
Yeah, it's a great company. Yeah. Covers all aspects of music. Yeah. It's really beneficial to the community.
Well, thank you very much. And anything you can tell us about Sweetwater?
That would be a Brad thing. I don't work for Sweetwater.
Well, kind of. All Brian and I do is their fittings. So we go along with Brad to elementary schools and do stuff like this and then try kids on different instruments. Just either for the fun of it or to actually help them choose the instrument that they'll play.
Now, how did playing music help you in life?
Oh, I can list all kinds of things.
Really?
It teaches responsibility. You have to practice in order to be good. It teaches a good work ethic. It teaches teamwork because you're playing all the time with other people.
And it teaches you pride in yourself.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Because you learn
self-confidence.
Yeah.
Yep.
Very good.
Lots and lots of benefits to music.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Down the hall from the music store, and we teach private one-on-one lessons. So any instrument you can think of, we pretty much have an instructor who will teach it.
Wow.
Yeah. Today we brought with us some ukuleles so that everyone can try out an instrument if they haven't already before, and we're pairing up with the Aaron Stone Memorial Fund for their mobile garage band. So everyone can try out an instrument today.
Okay, and what's your name?
I'm Megan. I'm an academy coordinator.
Okay, yeah. Megan, who do you have with you?
And this is Maria. She's also an academy coordinator.
What do you play, Maria?
I play the clarinet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what do you play?
I sing and I play the piano.
Oh.
Yeah.
Whoa. Uh-oh.
Oh, what that was. Okay, you sing and play the piano.
Yeah.
What did you learn to play the piano?
I learned the piano starting at age 5 back in Connecticut, and I actually went to college for music and ended up here because of Sweetwater. So,
yeah.
And you, she grew up here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
And tell us how we can get a hold of, if we wanted to learn an instrument,
yeah.
How can we get a hold of you?
Definitely check out our website, academy.sweetwater.com. That's where we have a lot of information about our upcoming events, programs, and a little bit more information about all of our instructors as well to find the best fit for you. And also, you can get a hold of us by calling 260-407-3833.
Thank you
so much.
Of course.
Nice to meet you.
A lot of productions come through. It's rated highly among in the world because of the types of shows that they can bring in.
And that's the Embassy Theater.
Embassy Theater, downtown Fort Wayne in Jefferson.
And what's your next event coming up?
Oh, man, I don't know. We do have, maybe we can get this.
Okay.
These are some of the Broadway stage productions coming in.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
The Philharmonic Orchestra plays there sometimes.
Tell us your name again.
Ted.
Okay, Ted. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Have a good day. Stay cool.
Well, I'll try.
Hey, Tegan.
What's your name?
I'm Olivia Myers.
Hi, Olivia.
Hi.
And you look like a person.
Thank you. I'm actually a fairy.
A fairy?
Yeah.
Oh, good. What fairy are you?
I'm from Midsummer Night's Dream. Yeah.
Okay. Very
good. Thank you.
Actually, we were supposed to perform this ballet last year, but COVID hit. So, you know, we're sort of bringing back, you know, just the costumes. We're not going to perform it anytime soon, but we just wanted to feel like we actually did some sort of something, you know? Yeah.
This is Katie Grable.
Hi, Katie Grable.
And are you a fairy? I am not. I am Cinderella's fairy godmother. Oh, okay. I know. I feel very important right now. Yeah. So Cinderella's like very sad. She wants to go to the ball. So then her fairy godmother comes up out of nowhere. And she's like, bibbidi bobbidi boo. And then Cinderella gets to go to the ball with her glass slippers.
There's where she meets the prince.
Right. Yeah, yes.
And you have somebody
here? Yes, TK.
Hi, I'm TK.
Are you also in the opposite?
Yes, I am. Well, it's been like very life-changing for me. Yeah, I've learned a lot of like discipline, life skills, while also learning ballet.
Would you recommend that?
I would. I would.
Help you in life so far?
Yes, it has. Just how to be like a better person, how to be kind, I'd say. Yeah.
Etiquette's a big thing. Yeah. Etiquette, voice, yeah.
Like, yeah. Time management, we have to have a very strict schedule. Yeah. We wake up really early, we gotta get all our school done, other extracurriculars, and then we go to ballet.
And how can someone join you?
By showing up, auditioning, and we have amazing teachers that will judge and place you on the level that suits you best. And they're on.
Is there a number or a website you can
Get? Yes, fortwayneballet.org, and on their website has their email, their Facebook, their phone numbers. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And what type of talent are you looking for?
Truly, if you can just like be on time with music, if you have a sense of fluidity and movement, and you have a desire for dance, that's truly it. Yeah. And then we will perfect the technique. They will perfect the technique for you.
Yeah.
I don't think, I was not very good when I started at all.
Yeah.
I was just having fun and
just like a joy of dance.
Yeah.
Just like showing up every day and working hard. Yeah. The teachers will do the rest.
Yeah.
Very good. You agree with that?
I do agree with all of that.
Thank you.
Rig-a-jig-jig
and away we go. Away we go. Away we go. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go. Hi ho, hi ho, hi ho. As I was jumping down the street, down the street, down the street. As I was jumping down the street, hi ho, hi ho, hi ho. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go. Away we go. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go. Hi ho, hi ho, hi ho.
Saturday. I love y'all on this Saturday.
Sunshine love.
So this next song we're going to do.
Another one.
Written by Devin and I. I'm stalling trying to catch my breath for this one. I don't know if y'all peep game, but bear with me.
I think that turned the heat up.
It won't stir from here.
Give it up one more time for yourself.
Midnight Mimosa.
Midnight Mimosa.
Midnight Mimosa.
That's right.
I think the arts are so important always, but especially right now, is this chance to really express ourselves and use our emotions and get up some of that energy that we've had kind of bottled up for a while. We are the Fort Wayne Dance Collective. If you like what you saw, or if you would like to dance with us, we are located on the corner of Clay and Berry, which is just a few blocks from here. We start our fall session of classes next week. We literally have something for everyone, from like three-year-olds to senior citizens. Everybody can dance, as far as I'm concerned, and that's the truth. But we have ballet, jazz, hip-hop, belly dancing, tap, tai chi, Zumba, yo, like pretty much anything you could think of, we probably offer it. So if you guys are interested, we also are at a booth over on Freedom Square, right across the street, or not even across the street, literally right at the door. So I really encourage you guys to check us out. And if you are a teenager looking to perform, I'm always looking for new pineapples. So thank you guys so much for supporting us and for supporting the arts, and enjoy the rest of your day.
From all of us at Parkview Health, have a healthy, happy holiday.
Jingle bells chime in, jingle bell time. Snowing and blowing, a bushel of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bells chime in, jingle bell time. A jingle bells chime in, jingle bells time. Dancing and prancing in jingle bells square. In the frosty air, what a bright shine.
the jingle bell.
www.burnsville.org/traffic.
Sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today, yeah.